Will you share your ongoing expansion plan details?
Naini is on a big expansion plan, and right now we are producing close to 10,000 tons of writing and printing paper every month, and we are going to more than double the capacity, and we have already got the environment clearance for our new expansion plan. So it is threefold. First of all, we are putting up a hardwood fiber line. Initial capacity would be 300 tons per day, but later on it would be expandable to 375 tons a day. Simultaneously, we are putting up a new recovery island with a new recovery boiler of 700 tons per day capacity from Andritz, and along with that we are putting up new evaporators, plus a new cast sizing line and a lime kiln from Walmart. In the second phase, we are planning to install a production line for paper / board. Yeah, so we have got several options open for that. We have yet not finalized which product to manufacture. We are thinking of a board machine, / writing printing paper machine, / some specialty paper, or maybe a tissue line. So we are studying the market. We are studying various technologies. We are also very conscious of the fact that single-use plastic has been banned. So what impact will it have on the paper demand for flexible packaging? So we are studying that segment as well. So we have got various options for that. So by the end of this financial year, we should be in a position to really decide which product to manufacture with this excess pulp we'll be having.
Okay. Last time you have given me indication that you may go in the packaging grade section like SBS, FBB board, FBB. Sir.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I'm saying. We can go for packaging board also, but market is growing for packaging board, but it's still, I mean, a lot of mills have come up with packaging board. It's still a couple of plants are in pipeline. So we have to really study the market, the demand and supply situation. So that is one of the options, of course. But apart from that, we are studying flexible packaging paper as well, which is a very different kind of section and very new to India. Very few mills are making it right now. So packaging is, of course, an option for us. Yeah.
What is the investment size involved in this investment, sir?
You see, I mean, historically, paper industry is highly capital intensive. I mean, when you say investment, these are to the tune of, right now in the first phase, whatever we are investing is around 600 to 650 crores. In the second phase, it is going to be anywhere between 600 to 700 crores.
Okay. So you are targeting on the export, the product will be used completely in the Indian market, sir?
You see, it would be both. We are targeting both domestic market as well as export market. You see, export market is always very volatile. So we will be having a switching combination. Whenever we find exports viable and attractive, we can go towards that. Otherwise, we have to cater to the Indian market. So of course, export is one of the target markets.
Any new product you have showcased in current export?
Oh yes, we have launched a couple of products day before yesterday on the very first day of the exhibition, and one of the product was called Double P. Yeah, I mean, we can see that, we can show you outside. Double P is for printing purposes. It's a surface size paper, and the second one is K2, that is non-surface sized. So we have launched two products. The expansion plan.
When you start your first phase of expansion, once you complete, what will be the date of the commencing project?
First phase of the expansion plans would be over by October 2020, and the second phase by November, December 2021. Yeah.
Who are the supplier of this?
Yeah, we
plant and machinery.
Right. So we are very choosy of our suppliers. We want not only good technology suppliers but also process suppliers. We want somebody who can help us in process engineering also. So we have shortlisted, Walmart is there, Foyth is there, Andhra is there. There are some world-renowned suppliers. So we'll be selecting one of those suppliers. And Gapcon Balmer is also there. So PMP is there. So we'll be selecting out of these.
Okay, fine. How do you see the future of Indian chip industry, sir?
You see, I've been in this line for the past, in this industry for the past almost 24 years now. And I have been hearing one statement since beginning. However might be your present, your future is always good. So similarly, I would say even in 2019, I would say future of paper industry is good. There is growth, there is demand growth. So, I mean, it is good. So this is the paper. This is 115 GSM, high bright paper. Similarly, we got 80 GSM.
So
yeah, this is surface size paper. Surface size paper, and with very good optical properties and strength properties and printability for this. Yeah. So, and the second product we launched is A2. Sorry, this is for notebook manufacturing. These are the specifications. This is high bulk paper for notebooks, and with good brightness levels and good smoothness levels. So this is the paper we have launched for notebook manufacturers. So I would say these are two customer delights we have offered during this PaperX. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.